Riley, do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Oh, yes, I know the Muffin Man, who lives on Drury Lane.
Forget about the Muffin Man, mate. It's all about the Gingerbread Man today, because he's kicking in the front door, coming across the board as a soon-to-be 16-16.
That's, I mean, this is, what is this? Like, how is this even possible? And what is even better about this? It can't be blocked. Pay one mana, can't be blocked, 16 damage. At your dome on turn 4.
I don't want any gingerbread! Lesson in reading the flavor text here, Riley. You want to read Bone Crusher Giant for me?
Yeah, look, it does have that hidden line of text amongst the shock and the 4-3 body. It does 2 damage to if you target it. And this is basically the opponent here was just going to win if they did anything other than target their own creature with a Colossus. And instead, they decided to lose.
Bold move, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off for him.
It has not paid off at all. He's punted it right up the field.
Asian Avenger here, Riley, is a hungry, hungry boy. The clans need a feed, and he's got just the thing for him. He's going to gobble up a lot of food.
Yeah, this is not a card that we've learned to play around in Standard. Rampage of the Clans is sort of, you know, draft bulk rare. And now all of these foods turning into 3-3s, which, you know, you expect with Okko, but not all in one go. And definitely not for a big lethal attack for 18.
Yeah, we're all going around to Crin's place for pizza tonight, and he's got plenty to share. Stanislav Sivka, Pro Tour winner here, Riley, has started by donating his Paradise Druid in exchange for Chris Kvartek's 3-3 Island. But that is only the start of this big brain play, Riley.
Yeah, it's not surprising to see old Stanislav with a 500 IQ plays here, because Deputy of Detention, now that he's given away his own Paradise Druid, Deputy of Detention all of a sudden looking very tasty indeed.
There's so many things at play here. The Deputy of Detention can only target the Paradise Druid because they're both tapped. He can only cast Deputy of Detention because he has exactly a Temple Garden, because that gives him a white and a green from the Nissa bonus, and the land that Nissa animated is Vigilance, so remains untapped. He can only target both Deputy Druids because they're both tapped. And if his Deputy then dies, he gets his one back as well. This is more skillful magic than I will ever play in my entire life.
Yeah, that's right. He's unlocked more skill points in this single clip than we'll ever spend in a career.
We are going to see Theo Moutier, whose name I've certainly butchered, probably just butcher Seth Manfield here, with one of the riskiest cards in Standard, right?
Yeah, we talk about all-in cards, Dennis. Chance for Glory is exactly that. See a big attack here, and Manfield and Moody are here. The pace of the game slows down. This is what happens with high-stakes magic. You're thinking through every single potential outcome. And you can see Mutia is going to take his time in firing up this Chance for Glory. But it is enough. It's not just chat lethal, Dennis. It's actual literal lethal.
Yeah, it's not. You're right. It's not chat lethal. It is enough to get him across the line here. Chance for Glory makes everything on his side of the board indestructible. And he has one more turn to finish Seth off. But thankfully, that is exactly all the time he needs.
Exactly. Only 3 blockers left for Manfield. And there's going to be 6 attackers, including that big flampling Crisis. And that's going to be enough. That is actually going to lose Manfield the game. So Chance for Glory living up to its name there, Dennis.
Very nice. He only has 2 blockers left, so get ready for that in the comments, but whatever. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you have your own suggestion for MTG Top 5, tweet them using the hashtag MTGTop5, or post them on the Channel Fireball Discord server in the hashtag MTG Top 5 chat room.